The path opens when the waters are full. A great line to start this episode on. Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy. Welcome back to more Okamiden. In the last episode, we got here to the five-story pagoda, obtained the power of water, and in this episode, we are going to be continuing on through the five-story pagoda. That is so cool, like how it just goes all over the place and like makes the frame rate freak out. It's just like, oh, I didn't know you were going to do that. So, I'm glad that we finally have the power of water because it's just kind of one of those powers where you keep feeling like you need it all the time, and it just kind of is torturous until they finally give it to you, so I'm glad that we got it taken care of. Now, here we finally get the introduction to this. See a torch, a spike floor, and I know, we can use water spout, right? Don't worry about a water source, you always have one. Just draw a line from me to the torch. So, Nami's hair doesn't just look like water, it is water. So, now we can use it. Before, it doesn't let you. Water is my element, so it's mine to command. I only have enough to power to extinguish a torch or two, but if I had the wet jewel and dry jewel back, then I could use the power of the oceans themselves. So, we finally have the ability to use that on command, so I really like how they work that into this. She's a bit more interactive than Kuni was, and you're actually going to see more of that in a bit, but I really like how they work that into her design, I guess, just the fact that she has water on her person so you can use that. So anytime that these ignite, we can just draw a line from Nanami to them that will instantly stun them, making them completely helpless. They will reignite after a little bit, but it's not that big of a deal. As you can see right there, it's going to try to reignite. We just blow it out again. Not really blow it out, just extinguish it again. Blow out. Yeah, blow out a torch with water. I have no idea how that would even work, but hey. And did I miss getting the floral finisher because Nanami attacked? Actually, no, wait, I didn't? Oh, wow, he dropped a demon bone. That was when I was like, oh, whoa, okay. So at least we took care of that. Want to just use water on them as they're going down. Don't let Nanami finish them off. They do take a little bit of damage from water when they're vulnerable, I believe, as well. So if you want to use that, you can. Extinguish you, hit 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 you. It's like he's playing poker with us, guys. So he's going down. Let's use water spout and kaboom! We get three demon bones. So very, very helpful enemy to grind against. If you find any demon scrolls that give you fire eyes, if you want demon bones, that is the best way to get demon bones in the entire game. So should you want that, is your tip. Let's just dodge like nuts for no reason. So there we got a left arm. As you can see there, she's just making up like, hey, drop something. We won't know what that is until a little bit. And I was actually kind of hoping that we'd find out like right on this floor so I could be like, by a little bit, I mean like 10 seconds from now, but unfortunately luck would not have that. Now, what's really cool is if you draw like a perfectly straight line, you will make a power slash despite the fact that that was in the water. So, should you want to, you can take care of that. And as you saw there, the ink was alternating between red and blue as I was drawing. So it was recognizing it's like, okay, it could be guidance or water spout. Is he going to connect it to a target that needs to be extinguished? Or is he going to connect it to a point that he wants Nanami to move to? I really like how they do that. Again, I thought that was a big improvement over Okami, getting to know what it's recognizing your drawing as before you finish, before you submit it, so there's no nasty surprises like, no, I didn't mean power slash, I meant stopping time. I don't know. I think there was one time that actually happened in the first, I don't know. I'm just trying to use some kind of example. But yeah. I wasn't trying to use power slash, I wanted you to light stuff on water. I don't know, light stuff on water? I don't know. So, got some more white toads here. Of course, as always, if you want some ink, you can go ahead and kill them, which I think I will do just because I'm starting to run a bit low. Well, not really running low. I'm a wimp if I think this is running low. Maybe I'm just spoiled by Okami where it's always full. Right here, we use the cherry bomb. And again, this is, I think, an instance where I can point something out. Now, Skyward Sword did fix this a bit in the Zelda series, but so one thing that I've always liked about Okami is that it plays very similar to Legend of Zelda, but you use all your powers throughout the entire game. That was an issue that a lot of Zelda games suffered from for quite a while, namely Twilight Princess and games like that. Like, they really did suffer from that issue where it was always just You use the item you get in that dungeon, it eats up inventory space, and you never ever use it again. Okami doesn't really do that in either game of it, in its series. So, that's one thing that I always liked, because even though Skyward Sword was a bit better about it, it still is kind of a problem with the Legend of Zelda series, and this doesn't have that. So, if you want a Zelda, game where that doesn't happen, this could be a good game for you. Another thing is that if you want, I guess, even though I personally like Phantom Hourglass and Spirit Tracks, if you want a Zelda-like game on the DS that doesn't make you use the touchscreen for everything and you can use the buttons, this might also be a game for you. Because, well, obviously, I'm moving using the D-pad. So it'd be kind of weird playing this game with the touchscreen when the touchscreen is used for the drawing. So it still is, you know, different and still is really nice, but, you know, traditional control scheme. So if you prefer the traditional control scheme, this could be a good game for you as well, so. Zelda fans would like this, all that, so I don't know why I'm talking about this so late in the series. Well, not really late, I mean, this is still pretty early. I mean, pretty long game, but. Let's grab you. The Buddha carving. So, we got yet another antique. Let me just make sure that I know where that is. There we go, Buddha carving. Okay, I was trying to make sure that, that actually can't. It's kind of weird, but like the Buddha carving always kind of stood out to me as kind of those weird collectibles, and I'm always like, wait, is that really an antique or not? Even though I kind of know that it is, I'm just like, is it really? I don't know if it is. I don't know, guys. I hear we're trapped in this room with these white toads, so we have to fight them. Now, everything I see says the white toads are missable. I'm not sure if that's really the case because you have to fight them in this room, but I would still go and fight some just to be sure because I've seen places cite them as missable even though you're required to fight some in that room, so I don't know for a fact if they are or not, but I guess that's really all I can say about it. So, this in here are some new enemies. These are some flame boulders. They are basically just a combination of death boulders and fire eyes. Nothing really special there. They die to one hit if you kill them right off the bat. Not really any difficult at all to fight. No real challenge at all. Here we go. Kill him. And is that it? Come on. You know what? I'm going to extinguish you. And that took care of him instantly. So now we can move on, and what do you know? We have fire bars, a la Super Mario Brothers. So we can actually shrink them by using Nanami, or we can just walk on through. Come on, 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 okay. Now right up here, this is a really, really cool puzzle. I like this one a lot. So, she says that we're gonna need to use the brush several times to do this. So, we want to use Nanami to, I guess, shrink down that fire bar just to make things a bit easier on us. You can't actually fully get rid of it if memory serves. No, it doesn't target it a second time. So, we'll shrink both of those down just to make things a bit more convenient. I have no idea why you'd just shrink fire and not get rid of it, but okay. So, we let Nanami off here. And that didn't last very long. That kind of sucked. So, we pull her out over here. Get past the fire bars. I don't care what anyone says, I'm gonna keep calling them fire bars. And then we pull her to the chest, which she could not reach before on her own. And I wish I could get rid of these fire bars and not have to worry about them. I suppose they didn't want to like take all sense of keeping you on your toes out of this puzzle, so that's probably why. But still, it's like, I wanna not have to do that! I don't know why I sounded so whiny about that. It's just, jeez, I am a wimp if I thought that was bad. I'm just like, oh, what, I have to dodge fire! Mommy, this video game's not being very nice! I can sound really pathetic when I want to, wow. Apparently somebody's been rubbing off on me, I don't know. So how about you come over here. You come up. Come up. Ugh. Come over here and give me the freaking left arm. Okay. So we have two left arms. I've heard of having two left feet, but two left arms, it's kind of weird. So we got some stairs right here that we're going to want to take really quick before we fight those enemies, because you can guess the enemies are blocking the required path. We got two chests that are back up here on the fifth floor. We have an Isun Masterpiece Part 2. And we have a sinker. So that is another one of the fishing manifest items. We have one other to find in here. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're going to be like, wait a minute, why not three? If you're going through this area and you're missing one item in the fishing manifest and you're just like, God, I can't find this last item, don't worry. Only two of them are here. So don't get all hung up on trying to get that last fishing manifest item because you are not missing anything. There really are just two of them in this dungeon. So right here we have the introduction of a new enemy. These are the ice lips. Now, what's really cool is, in Okami, you might recall that I complained that ice is its own element and not just part of water, and it was kind of disappointing. It was kind of a disappointing power as a result. Well, check it out. Ice is no longer its own unique element in Okamiden. Ice and water are now the one and the same, so anything that's ice, you can use right from the beginning from having water spout. I am so glad they made that change, because I used to always think that ice was just such a weird power, like it was just kind of the one that really stood out and just didn't belong now. There you saw I had another status, that is freeze. You can have that inflicted on you in battle now. If you get hit by fire, it will defrost you, and I screwed up getting the floral finisher on that guy. What kind of sucks is now that the fire eye is no longer the annoying enemy to fight, now we have the ice lips where we don't have what power we need to fight it, so we kind of just have to deal. Come on. Come on, Ice Lips. Come on, Lipsy. Lipsy, come on. Come on, Lipsy. Come on, Lipsy. Okay. Hit him. Or her. I honestly could more so believe the Ice Lips being a her. Can I power slash that back? No, I can't. I'm definitely not going to do well on time here, and you guys are just going to love me here. You know what? If I legitimately don't do well on time, I will do my best to say the thing that everybody's wanting me to hear. So let's see. Let's see if I actually do bad on time here. Come on. Come on, Ice Lips. I just need to hit you one more time. Come on. I just need to hit you one more freaking time. Okay. If I do bad on time here, I will say the thing that everybody's been wanting me to say. Guess you aren't getting to hear it then. Okay, fine. I'll say it anyway. I love the art direction in this game. Do you guys really like the art direction in this game? Because I like the art direction in this game. Because the art direction in this game is so nice. Ha! You thought I was going to say, what do you mean I did badly on time? I got you good. Okay, let's keep going. God, I'm just having so much fun here. This is just... Oh, God. Let's just go up here. Right here, we have a new creature. This one is also missable, so you're going to want to fight this. I believe this is called a fox pot. Let me make sure. Excuse me, Pot Fox is what it's called. Of course, based on the Kitsune of ancient times. And right here, this Kanon statue is missing some arms. I wonder. Now, of course, I think everybody knows about Kanon and that arm of many hands and all that, so don't really think it's overly necessary to me to go over that because it's actually quite an obvious one. Let's keep hitting you. Come on, die. You can alternatively use Power Slash on their tails to take care of them quickly, but I don't really think it's overly necessary. Right here, we want to swing around and grab that chest as Nanami. Get that. And bring it back to Chibi! She actually is a pretty fast swimmer, a lot faster than Ami was. Ami was a slow swimmer, dang. Like, I remember that being one thing I actually kind of didn't like about Okami, was just how slow you'd swim, and to get some treasures that were, like, off in the distance and, like, got in a bunch of areas, it was just, it took so long to do. We want to blow out that torch really quick. Just trust me on that. We got Death Boulders over here, not that they're a missable enemy by any stretch, so grab that. And then we want to get rid of those two. That'll open that door. And let's see what the sign says. The path remains closed while the flames burn bright. Well, too late for that information. About as helpful as the info blocks in Yoshi's Island. There's a big crack here. So, as if it wasn't obvious enough, we draw a cherry bomb because Nanami's like, hey, you need to blow something up here. Well, I shouldn't say that. But this, the perspective in this room always bothered me. It looks like that hole is way up above you, but no, you just kind of... Okay. You just kind of walk into it. Like, you have to check it first, but you just walk in. It's really weird. So, in this room, check it out. Somehow, there's a starry sky viewable from inside a pagoda on the third floor out of five. No idea how that works, but it's gonna get me something, so I'm not going to argue against it. I don't know, maybe it's supposed to be like spiritual, like you can see the starry sky despite being inside. So, ooh, more stars. So here, we have the other instance of a monkey god, because one of them, Water Lily God, was cheated, as we talked about before. So no Water Lily, no ice. But we do have Guidance, which is a new power. For those who didn't play Okami, there's three monkey gods in Okami. There's only two in this one is mainly what I'm getting at. Now, I like this monkey god a lot more. It's so much cuter. I mean, just look at that! Skills. He caught that with his mouth. Oh, child of the great sun, I am the young Tsutagami. Just when there was despair that we would not meet, you called on me, and I am overcome with joy. The power of the twirling vine is yours. We got the God's power of vine, huh? That's simply divine! Ha ha! Have you ever heard of Tsutagami before? He has the power to control vines. He can use the power of vine to connect to the cone on a blossom. So, we just need to draw a line from Chibi, as you can see there. It's green. And the ink itself turns green when we connect to a cone on a blossom. It's odd is that you don't draw a line from the blossom to you. You draw it from yourself. I have no idea why they changed that, but they did. So here we have vine. Nothing more complicated than just draw a line from yourself to a blossom. And this is basically your hookshot, for those of you who play Legend of Zelda. So, we will grab this. We get a monkey figurine. And we want to get that. And the vine actually has a new use. It was not gone over in there, but we will find out about it soon enough. We want to go ahead and do that. We want to grapple our way over a bit more so. That. So we can get on top of an upside down cone on a blossom, but you can't connect it to another one while you're falling. Okay, so we need to move quick if we're falling. So this is really cool and all that we have the power of vine. So I think we're gonna end this off here since we got ourselves a new power and we got really far into the dungeon. So next time on Okamiden, we are gonna be pressing forth more through the five-story pagoda and finding out what is beyond here. See you guys then.